Today, I was out for a drive and I felt the dawn has done came, and I have not discussed it, and I needed to talk about it and discuss it. So, without further ado, we're gonna get in today to The Weeknd's new album, Dawn FM. And man, that album is so fantastic. I've been a fan of The Weeknd for a while, since like Beauty Behind the Madness, technically. Because I can't feel my face and all that stuff, blew up, and so that was pretty much how a lot of people found out about him. But I had heard some. It turned out I had heard some of his songs before that were from the Kissland album, but I just didn't know. Professional. What's the one? The World one. I forgot. But yeah, there's a couple songs from Kissland that I had heard and was like, oh shit, this was The Weeknd, and. So, hearing everything that he's done so far has just been great. But I can honestly say that I'm a big fan of music, and I would never have imagined his music going the route that it went. I mean, yeah, he was like, people were saying he was the next Michael Jackson and stuff, but Bruno Mars and Justin Timberlake have done the same thing, and they sang the same style of songs, and it wasn't like they were, deemed as like the next Michael Jackson right away. It took time. So I would have expected the same from him. But when his last album, After Hours, came out, I made a video, saying how I felt like that album done broke the United States. And that was what really initially caused the lockdown, was because The Weeknd, his new album came out. And it came out, and then a couple of days later, I think the day it came out, yeah, the 20th, was when the lockdown happened. So when I had heard, and when he had put out that he was gonna have a new album come out after quarantine, or after, for 2022, into 2021, everyone was excited. Everyone was ecstatic. They were like, "Let's go. Let's see what happens." And yeah, he released it all quick. Apparently, he said, he tweeted out saying that let's just release it or whatever. And then he released the album cover, which was like awesome. Him as like an old guy. I mean, it was just fucking cool. And all his album covers always have his face, or like it's something about him that changes. So like Starboy, he lost his when he cut his hair and everything, his crazy hair, and then since then it was just really cool headshots. But yeah, so Dawn FM, it is fantastic. If I could say anything, it really gives me a Songs for the Deaf vibe. My favorite band is Queens of the Stone Age, and Songs for the Deaf is like one of their greatest albums, and the whole album is set to be like a radio station, or like you're changing through radio stations, and that's pretty much what this was. But instead of you're going through radio stations, this album was its own station. 103.5 Dawn FM was the set station that all these songs are playing on. So it was a really great concept. The Weeknd has been doing fantastic stuff with his, concepts of his albums and his music videos and everything. I mean, it's just phenomenal. The music videos that came out with this album, awesome. Take My Breath, the first single, fantastic. Sacrifice, second single, fantastic. So as far as I'm concerned, hands down, just awesome. Everything The Weeknd's done so far has just been fantastic. But yeah, so let's get on into this. So Dawn FM, first track off the album, is the start of turning on the radio station. And I think he had said that it was supposed to be where you're you're dying, or you're entering purgatory, a state of purgatory where you're not quite anywhere yet, you're just leaving your body. So it's like, you're dying and your soul is going up to heaven or whatnot, and this is what you're pretty much hearing. And the beauty of it is Jim Carrey is the host. Jim Carrey turns out to be your host, and it's just fucking awesome. I mean, of course, The Weeknd being Canadian, he had to get like the next best Canadian person to do this with him, and Jim Carrey is hands down the best person that you could have chose. So, but yeah, let's get it started. Let's turn your dials on, and let's find this right. Let's find this station, and tune on in to Dawn FM.
You are now listening to 103.5 Dawn FM.
So yeah, very awesome. I love the way that it starts out with, 103.5 Dawn FM, and like Jim Carrey bringing you in. It's just awesome. I mean, I could never, if I could put some type of spoken word song or album with stuff like that together, I would love to have Jim Carrey. I mean, man, I hope he like furthers his career in this of just doing random cameos in music. It's fucking awesome. He already paints and stuff. It's freaking beautiful. But I love the lyrics, how he's, you know, this part I do alone, and, you know, this is it. This is the start of the album, what everyone's been waiting for, the follow-up to After Hours, and man, he fucking delivered. And then track number two, Gasoline. And pour out the gasoline.
I know there's nothing after this. After this. Obsessing over aftermaths, apocalypse, and hopelessness.
Gasoline is awesome. Gasoline was the first, you know, track of the album, essentially. And fuck, the way he sings it, I mean, God, I don't really have much to say about this song, but his singing fucked me up. Right when the words came out of his mouth, I was like, is that the Weeknd? Like, oh my God, he went full 80s. He straight up went back in time. I was flabbergasted. I couldn't believe it. But the song is just awesome. Hands down the shit. He released the music video for it, and like his old self is like, his young self like beats the shit out of his old self. Like he's like in a weird purgatory hell. Like, it's awesome. You know, the Weeknd is always going through trials and tribulations and dealing with his own demons, and it's just, that was the coolest way he could have put of him dealing with shit in his own way, of just fucking himself up over and over again, because that's all he can do. You know, pour on the gasoline, it don't mean much to me. But yeah, and then it goes right on into track two, which has got to be my favorite track of the album, how do I Make You Love Me. I say, how do I make you love me? How Do I Make You Love Me was definitely my, like, God, I just couldn't. I was like, oh my God, the falsetto in the chorus, and like the badass electronic like keyboard beats and shit, and like, I just, fuck, I could not believe it. I couldn't believe the gravity that this song held, because it was just, and the weight it held, because it was just fucking awesome. Couldn't believe it. Fuck yeah, fuck yeah, Abel. Fantastic song. Fantastic song. And then, of course, it leads into then the first single off the album, Take My Breath. And man, I gotta say, my breath was completely taken away when I first heard this song, because that whole ending was like what he put as like the teaser, and it had like the dawn rising or whatever. And man, just that, like, I don't know what it is about the Weeknd, but he just is able to put in the most beautiful, smallest little musical intonations and like tidbits, you know. And you know, I mean, How Do I Make You Love Me just had the best, like, you know, like no, 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 and like, you know, just little bits of like, ooh, like he does and shit, and it's just fucking awesome, you know. And Take My Breath, having that fall, that crescendo ending was just like, yes, it was just phenomenal, hands down, fantastic. I mean, you know, this one and Sacrifice, you know, being the two singles off the album, Sacrifice, you know, I would say is a bit better than Heartless. I mean, because Heartless was, I mean, it was, I'm not saying it wasn't good, but I feel like this Sacrifice has more of that dance vibe. Pulling away from just being a rap song, but his raps, you know, his flows, whatever you want to say, are really good anyway. So, but I mean, you know, and then Blinding Lights, I would say, would kind of actually be better than Take My Breath, but Take My Breath's ending part, fuck, blows that part of the song, blows Blinding Lights out of the water, because the only reason Blinding Lights made it so far, I feel, was because of the intro of that, you know, dun, 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 dun. Like, I heard it, so I loved it for the first like 2 months, and then after that, when I started hearing it everywhere, I was like, man, this album is so good, and there's so many other songs on it, y'all just blowing the shit out of this song. So, you know, between Take My Breath and Sacrifice, I would say Take My Breath was better, but Sacrifice as a whole song I think was just a bit more solid, you know, but it was still good. Still fantastic.
That's it. Looking back now, I didn't know what it was supposed to be. And it's like raising kids, man. If you weren't raised, you don't know how to raise, you know? I just did the best thing I could with them because they know fucking well I love them.
And then you had A Tale by Quincy, which was cool. Fucking Quincy Jones discussing how, you know, growing up without a mom. I mean, that was beautiful. I grew up without a father, kind of, pretty much. So I totally feel that, you know, of being, you know, missing half your parent. And it was kind of beautiful to have that in there. And of course we had, Out of Time. I'm actually surprised this wasn't like the second single, but it was definitely like the hidden song that like you had to listen to the album to find, because it's awesome. I mean, you know, Out of Time, you know, it's traditional Weeknd. He's out of time. He wishes he could do this and that or this with everybody, but he's like, you know, gone too far. They've gone too far, and he just can't. It's out of time. Can't keep it up with you. And then of course the ending has Jim Carrey again doing more like, you know, radio host speech, and it's just fucking awesome. Fucking thank you, Jim, for just agreeing to do this, and thank you, Abel, for just putting him in this. It's just awesome. You guys just listen to this album. My review is gonna do jack shit to like compared to like actually listening to this album headphones on, you know, in the evening or early dawn of the morning and just like playing it all the way through. Like it's a different type of vibe. It's fucking awesome. And then we got Here We Go Again, which featured Tyler the Creator, which was pretty cool because it's, you know, the Weeknd, Here We Go Again, dealing with women and bitches trying to find their way into his life, or him finding his way into other bitches' life only to find out that they bitches. I mean, it's crazy. It's the Weeknd, traditional Weeknd.
This love is strong to me. Some things can change, go wrong with me. We don't know how it's going to be. Forever is too long to me. We don't need the government involved because we like to touch. We don't need no.
And then Tyler the Creator, I mean, fucking, that guy's a shit anyway. I mean, I'm not really into rap. Don't really have any favorite rappers, but I would definitely say Tyler the Creator is one of the faves. You know, Kid Cudi, all those fools that, like, you know, be rapping about that real shit. So that was just, it's a beautiful song on its own. And then it's followed by Best Friends, which is, fuck, every girl I'm pretty sure was just weeping over this song because it's about, you know, having sex with the, or you know, having sex with those friends with benefits, pretty much, you know. And then
it's a cup in a bout of toxic love. It tore us apart. Things you want, I'm not looking for. You're my best friend now. You're my best friend now.
And that saying that the girl, like, I don't want to be friends no more, or like the guy even saying, I don't want to be friends no more, and like, I can't do this anymore. And like, you know, in 2022, dating ain't easy, you know, all this mask fishing bullshit about not knowing how someone's face looks like, all you get are their eyes. doesn't end well for a lot of people nowadays. So at this point, for all the friends, everyone's friends be fucking, and it's like, now the friendships are ruined. And now you're just miserable in 2022, and you probably got the Rona, or the Rona flu, or whatever it is. But yeah, Best Friends was cool. Definitely that was like a whatever track for me. But like that intro, though, the intro of it was sick. Like the whole hard synth keys, I mean, fuck. And then his rapping, or like, you know, his flowing along with it, definitely fucking stellar. Definitely fucking stellar. But it does roll into my second favorite track off the album, Is There Someone Else? That song was good. Is There Someone Else? Like, just the intro alone with it. He's always good with using he's always good with using a little chipmunk girl voice or whatever, and like, oh, I love when he uses it, because it always just does good. It's fucking awesome. But again, traditional Weeknd song. Is there someone else? Is there someone else or not? Because I didn't know. I don't want to fucking be messing around with y'all, and then it turns out that, you know, you got someone else this whole time, or you're like playing the field with me. Like, fucking love the Weeknd, man. He's fucking, 2022 wasn't ready for this album. I guarantee you 2022 wasn't ready for this album. And then of course we got Starry Eyed, which is pretty beautiful. Just, you know, saying, let him be there. Let the Weeknd be there for you.
Let me be there. Let me be there for your heart. Let me be there. I can be there until you're home. You weren't touched by a man in so long, 'cause the last ton of words were too strong.
'Cause he's there for us, and that boy will never stop making music. And never stop, won't stop, never stop, won't stop him. But yeah, Starry Eyed was just beautiful. It's a short beauty, and I would definitely say it's, you know, again, for me, not a favorite, but it just shows the beauty and the range of his voice, because it's just like awesome hearing him hit those notes. I would say that some people said that this album kind of seemed like it was, sonically, that it kind of sounded the same. And honestly, like, every Weeknd album has, like, it's got its theme or its concept, but it does kind of follow like a similar tone. But I could give less of a fuck. Then we come on into Every Angel Is Terrified, which was a fucking doozy of a track.
Every Angel Is Terrified. Graphic, sexy, euphoric, provocative, edgy, thought-provoking, technically and visually stunning.
It's not even a track, really. It's like, I guess maybe he gave a speech somewhere, and then they recorded the speech, but the, I don't know, and then he turned into like a commercial. But the commercial is awesome, because at first I thought it might be Jim Carrey voicing it, but I think it's actually Abel voicing it, because given that he's done the stuff on Saturday Night Live and everything, I mean, I give him full props if he's actually like doing this as like a skit for himself, you know, euphoric, technically and visually stunning, you know, so-and-so says I can't keep my eyes off it. For only $4.99, you can have Afterlife. And Afterlife, I'm guessing, is a play on, you know, After Hours and, you know, what Dawn FM is all about, of like going off, you know, or like your soul going up to heaven. So it's like, you know, you could purchase your afterlife and make heaven what you want for only $4.99, you know, because that's what we are. We're in an era of capitalism and shit where everything you buy can give you happiness. So, you know, you could buy happiness in the afterlife. Like, it's genius. Like, you think you're going to hell? Don't you worry about it. Give us $4.99 and you'll go straight up to heaven. Like, fucking man, Abel, genius. At least that's how I interpreted. Remember, these are all just opinions. So y'all can think I'm wrong and I can think I'm right. Or I can think I'm like half right. And you all think I'm totally on the money. So whatever you want to take from it. But Every Angel Is Terrified. It was fucking cool. And then it went into my third favorite track, Don't Break My Heart. Oh, don't break it. Don't break my heart.
Don't break my heart.
Which was fucking awesome. Like, that song vocally is like my favorite song off the album, because I love how he sings it. You know, I don't think I can take it anymore. Like, how he has that, how he hits that low, like, same with Gasoline. Like, fuck, man. Like, his musical ranges are just broadening and he's just singing differently. And like, I love it, man. Keep it up, Weeknd. This song is so awesome. Again, don't break my heart. Don't break the Weeknd's heart. Stop breaking hearts out there, everybody. Just don't break your heart. Unless you got to do it and it's actually necessary and the bitch is crazy or the guy is crazy, then I guess you got to break some hearts here and there. But anyway, moving on. Then, of course, we have the most Michael Jackson track of all the tracks. Like, if Michael Jackson was, like, here today in 2022, this song is his track. You know, I heard you're married.
Me, I could tell you've been in control.
Yeah, I Heard You're Married is practically a Michael Jackson song. Like, the beat, like, that heavy, like, doom, 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 doom. Like, I mean, it's practically Smooth Criminal and most of the songs on Blood on the Dance Floor from Michael Jackson. Like, that's what it gave me feelings of. Not that he's copying any of that shit, but I'm just saying, it immediately brought me to that album of Michael Jackson and, like, Smooth Criminal, you know, doom, 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 doom. Same feeling of just heavy beat, drum and bass. I mean, it was fucking awesome. But again, traditional Weeknd song, like, you know, what's up, girl? Like, I heard you were married. Like, you know, I thought we were making it good, and you had me wrapped around your finger, and it turned out you had a ring on it as well. Like, fucking crazy ass. Like, love it. But, you know, musically, totally a Michael Jackson song. I could totally see, you know, this is like Billie Jean meets Smooth Criminal, but it's backwards Billie Jean, you know, like, it's, well, I guess it's still forwards Billie Jean, but still backwards Billie Jean, where the guy's like, hey, you already had a baby, you know, and you said you didn't have kids, where now in Billie Jean, you know, of course she's saying it's your kid. But yeah, I Heard You're Married, hands down, the most Michael Jackson song on the album. And then we have Less Than Zero, which is a like totally threw me out of left field. I mean, this song is a straight up 80s one hit wonder back in the day. I couldn't face you with my darkest truth of all. Oh, cause I can't get it out of my head. No, I can't shake this. Like, it had the, if this was in the 80s, this would totally be a one-hit wonder. Like, the keys, the do-na-na-na-na-na, the raising keys, everything, just beautiful. Holding the notes for the chorus, I can't get it out of my head. I mean, whole way through, nonstop, fucking awesome. I bow my head to you, Weeknd. You fucking killed it, And between having the album cover be the old guy, it's just like, man, like, I can only imagine what's next. But yeah, Less Than Zero, man. He's less than zero. Not quite a one. Oh, man. And then last but not least, the final track on the album, Phantom Regret, featuring my boy, the one, the only, Jim Carrey. All righty, then.
God knows life is chaos. But he made one thing true. You gotta unwind your mind, train your soul to align, and dance till you find that divine boogaloo. In other words, you gotta be heaven to see heaven.
And yeah, you know, fucking Jim Carrey, he does this whole poem. It's like it's a whole poem with, you know, the Weeknd doing like little coos in the background and shit. So beautiful. I was at loss for words. It's a great poem. You know, just Jim, I have no words. He went MIA for so long. People are giving him shit for everything he's been in lately, you know, and I think he's doing fine in Sonic, you know, as Mr. Robotnik, but man, this really just brought me into his world. I mean, I read his book, you know, Misinformation, Memoirs of Misinformation and whatnot, and loved his book, and I love, you know, the paintings that he's done and he's shown on his Instagrams and stuff. I think the paintings are great. So for what it's worth, you know, Jim, you're the man, and the Weeknd, you're the man, and you guys are right. You got to be heaven to see heaven, and that's all we got to do this year is just be heaven. We got to shine as bright as we can so that other people can be pulled out of the darkness or whatever depths of hell that they feel like they're stuck in, and just be there for them. And the Weeknd, thanks for being here for us. Thank you for releasing this album fresh, you know, for the new year. You know, this new year's been up and down, man. We're fucking flowing, you know. We got like bullshit happening and good shit happening, people passing, things going great. So it's just, you know, we got to hold it together, and the Weeknd is definitely holding us up. And you know, the Weeknd's coming. Just stay cool, stay clean, stay real, and just you know, try to be there for your fellow man or fellow woman's. And I love you guys. Peace. This has been Ghost on the Craig, And yeah, go check out the Weeknd's new album. Don FM is fucking fantastic. I guarantee you will love it, and you will not be let down.